Okay, today is day 14. Today was the final day for the stay alive guarantee for this Harlequin Tuskfish from Australia from petsolutions.com. They shipped their fish straight out of Los Angeles, and they guaranteed a pretty healthy fish, so they kept their part of the promise, and I'm pretty impressed. Part of my promise was to make sure the fish had a pretty stable, healthy living environment, and I did. As I showed you in the very first video, as I was acclimating it, I showed you that everything was at zero, including the nitrates. Part of my problem is I have allowed the nitrate levels to creep up slowly over the past 14 days, part and due by overfeeding just a little bit and not doing any water changes or very little. Other than that, I've maintained the filter floss and the filter socks. I cleaned those out at least once between the 14 days, maybe twice. And I do plan on doing a 10-gallon water change here this evening or tomorrow, just to bring those nitrate levels back down a little bit. Because as of right now, they're between, I'd say, 60 and 80. That's pretty high. If I had introduced this fish into high nitrate levels, the chances of it being comfortable and acclimating to that might have been a lot more difficult for it. Because higher nitrate levels can be toxic to fish over time, and their immune systems will crash eventually if it's kept at that level for too high. With that said, it's very important to be able to maintain that low nitrate level by doing periodic water changes and not feeding so much. Okay, so with that said, I'm just going to go ahead and feed the fish. Everything else, all the other water parameters look pretty good. I tested them out again, and the nitrite is zero, ammonia is zero, pH is at about 8.2, salinity level is 1.021, and everything else is pretty ideal for fish-only aquariums, except for the nitrate levels. I'll get that under control eventually. That's one of the toughest things to get under control for people that have fish aquariums. I'm going to feed them the krill first, a couple pieces of the krill. Yeah, make sure he gets some of that stuff. That's good for to help his coloration of vitamin C. Then I'll feed him the fish later, all the other goodies later. Here is a piece of fish that's going in there now. Seems to like that a lot. Trying to grab some piece of prawn now. Oh, he's almost gone after my finger, and the clownfish has got it. Lastly, I'll put in some scallop, if I can find some in there. It's a whole bunch of food. It's at the very bottom. I wanted to make sure it got that last. Another piece. That'll be a little quicker than that, Mr. Rass. You're gonna want to compete with the other fish later. Okay, so that's about it. Overall, I'm pretty happy with this fish. It's doing really well. And hope to continue to have it for a long, long time, as long as I have this aquarium. So, well, the main aquarium, at least. So, alright, thanks for watching. And thank you for enjoying the 14-day film extravaganza on the Harlequin Tuskfish from Australia. The next time you'll see it on film is when I introduce it to the main aquarium. Thanks.